Lately, all of us have been hearing the term metaverse. Over the years, this term has been commonly used by a large number of people. But what exactly is it? In simple words, let's say there's a virtual world where there are billions of people who interact with each other like in the real physical world. Whereas in this world we use computers and phones to collect information which has become portals to a 3D realm that is only bigger and better. Digital copies of ourselves move freely from one experience to another, maybe by taking our identities. Financial service. Building a system that connects both these worlds with our identity or avatar is one of the major steps which enables a shared metaverse, thus leading to the creation of a new level of reality that would be fully digital. Metaverse has impacted various industries, including the bank and other fintech sectors. Metaverse impact on the financial service shows the next evolutionary stage in banks and fintech industries. Starting from traditional banking, i.e., face-to-face to interactions to online transactions taking place through phones and computers. This represents the fifth stage of evolution in the banking and fintech industry, offering customers the experience of virtual banking. It was stated that by the end of this decade, the majority of people will be making use of virtual reality as an alternative source for customer transactions or any interactions taking place. Now let's look at an example here. Bank of America has launched a VR, virtual training, program that provokes people for real-life customer interaction. This is one of the most commonly asked questions here. Why would customers adopt the metaverse? Most people find their account to be quite boring and they want it to be fun. Having their own avatars in the metaverse will not only enable them to do face-to-face interactions but also check their account balance, pay their bills and make money transfers. Apart from customer interaction, it also opens them to various other fields like crypto investment, insurance policies, etc. Over the next few years, metaverse is expected to show itself primarily through virtual reality, a digital world that can be used for a variety of reasons. There are many ways this could develop through research, innovation, or policy. Mark Zuckerberg states that the metaverse is in the form of video games and claims that virtual reality will only replace only a handful of aspects of the human experience. Fashion industry. This year, the public witnessed the first ever Metaverse Fashion Week, which was brought out to be the most controversial topic spoken about. Now you can see a large number of digital fashion is being sold in the same way digital art is being sold. Well, how the times change. Currently, the fashion industry is creating awareness and working with fake developers to create more player outfits and skins for the avatars. Such examples like these show us that engaging in new markets like this increases revenue and is much more economical compared to traditional use. Now designers can make use of virtual collections without spending on materials or having to invest in them. Due to the latest technological advancements, a lot of people have been relying on online gadgets rather than the traditional method. The concept of working from home has become so prevalent after the world had been hit by the COVID pandemic. This is where the use of metaverse will be an advantage to the employees, as it helps them to work together in a virtual environment with proper interaction. It is also a huge plus point to the students, as they can attend classes by sitting at home and seeing their teachers in a virtual 3D world.